Life is so unusual sometimes. I don't understand how people can just think everything can be fine. I don't understand how they can just pretend to be fine, even with the nightmares in their head. Dad, I need answers. I need you. This world is making me go crazy and I don't know what to do. I have no answers, and I don't think I will ever find them, but I don't know how to live with this anymore. I don't know how to numb the pain.
Hello, Bertha. Yeah, I know I'm supposed to meet you at the kitty party today, but I'm so sorry I wasn't able to make it. You see, it's my daughter. The entire week I was so busy with my work and I wasn't able to spend time with her, and yesterday she seemed really, really worried and upset. I think she's missing her dad. You know the difficulty of being a single parent. Yeah, I've cooked lunch today. You know, the one she and her dad used to love having on Sundays. I just hope everything's fine. Yeah, okay, you guys have fun, okay? Bye.
Jenny?
Yes?
Could I have some tea, please?
In a minute.
Sure.
Sandra?
Good morning, princess. Now shake that sleep off and look what I have here in my hand.
You got a promotion again, Dad?
Well, it's a letter that says Miss Sandra Saldana has been accepted into the London School of Economics with a full scholarship.
Nothing, darling. I just thought you and I could live one of those normal Sundays we used to when your father was alive.
Yeah, those were the good days.
So, it's Christopher's wedding next week. Do you want to go shopping today?
No, Ma. I don't feel like attending any occasions.
Sandra, you've missed many occasions till now, and I never forced you. I think it's high time you come outside and meet your own family members at least. And soon it's going to be your wedding.
I don't want to get married. Mom doesn't understand anything. Is relationship and marriage all that is there? Our family. How can you even call them a family when you can't trust them? In fact, how can you trust anyone at all? I will never understand these people.
Stop reading those books for a while, Sandra. Let's go out shopping today.
No, Mom, I have to finish the book today because I have to start another tomorrow. And I have work to do, Mom. It's a very hectic weekend. I'm sorry.
May I have your attention, please? Ms. Sandra from the Department of Economics and Ms. Lavina from the Department of Psychology have been put in charge for the drama club for the school fest. Thank you.
Wow, this is so exciting. We have to win the first prize this time, Sandra. I'm so excited to be working with you. The principal told me you won many awards at drama when you were in school. We're going to be doing 12th Night. The school picked it.
12th Night by Shakespeare? I'm sorry, I don't believe it.
What do you mean you don't believe it? Look at her, she thinks too much of herself.
Maybe because she got graduated from London School of Economics.
I mean, why doesn't she like 12th Night? I think there's something wrong with her.
I can't agree more. I mean, she changed 3 jobs in 2 years.
Oh
yeah, I've heard about that. I mean, she's so fickle-minded, isn't she?
I don't think she's fickle-minded. She's so brilliant at everything. Have you seen her?
Have you ever seen her getting along with anyone? I mean, she's always in her own world.
Maybe she has some personal problem or some family issues.
Watching you for the past few days, you seem upset. Are you not happy with the drama that we've chosen?
No, nothing like that. I just don't believe in these things. So I don't know how I can help the students or be a part of it.
Good morning, Miss.
Good morning, Tanya. How are you?
I'm good, Miss. Thank you so much for counseling me the other
day. Anytime. I'm really happy to help.
It really helped me and I feel so relieved.
That's great.
My friend wants to speak to you as well.
Set up a drop by my office anytime she wants.
Okay. Thank you, Miss.
Bye.
Your
friends. Yeah, I've been working here for the past 10 years.
Should I talk to her? Should I tell her? Can she help me?
Do you think anger can be controlled?
I think if you know the reason, it can.
Can I talk to you sometime?
Sure, feel free to drop by my house anytime you want.
Thank you so much, I'll be great.
Thank you, sir. And thank you, Lavina, for all your love and support you have shown for this book.
Well, there was a very joyous, jaunty and jolly girl who lived a normal life. She was full of life, full of innocence. Life's happiness came unraveling one day when a male gender's evil intentions managed to scar her. In societal terms, they would name it sexual abuse. But in a girl's eyes, it's just plain silence, black spot and ringing mistake which has an impact on her day-to-day life, on her every action. The same merry girl had managed to drown in the ocean of despair after the incident. Nothing seemed right, no one seemed trustworthy, and more than anything, her existence seemed to be tagged in silence and grief. There were many questions but no answer, until one day, the existence of psychology, understanding of situation, and more than anything, help of a friend pulled her out. Her suffering ended when she realized that life had greater things to offer and it certainly isn't about clinging on to something, which isn't even her fault. The sessions helped, the support from a friend boosted, directed a positive conscience, and eventually her life is filled with happiness again. However, the scar still remains. This book is about every girl that has faced the pain. It's all about those evil hands that have caused the misery. With this book, I intend to spread the awareness of evil practices happening across the world. It's for all those women who were scared to step up, scared to accept the cruelty, and scared to live their life again.
I'm so proud of you, Sandra. You fought like a warrior. You took all your sadness and you just drowned it into inspiration. You are motivation for so many other women out there that are suffering the same as you.
I drew the sense from you, Lavina.
I know how hard it was for me to fight through this anguish, but you helped me, and I know why. The tears in your eyes during the book launch told me it wasn't just my story. You lived it too, and will be grateful to you forever, because you taught me how to fight my fears.
There was a time I used to look into my father's eyes. In a happy home, I was a king, I had a golden throne. Those days are gone, now the memories are